Hi everyone and welcome to the PrestaShop 1.7 tutorial video series. Today we'll be covering PrestaShop 1.7, which is the newest version of the PrestaShop software. I'm going to show you how to manage the administration area. Now that you've installed PrestaShop 1.7 and that you are properly logged into your administration area, you should make sure you can easily find your way through its administration interface, understand its notifications, and know where to find one specific bit of information. So let's go for an overview of the administration area. And firstly, the top bar. At the top of the back office is a white bar containing a handful of information and links. Quick access. This is the quick access links menu, presenting the most useful links. You can customize it by clicking on the manage quick accesses. The search field with a drop-down list. It enables you to search within the content of your shop. The shop name link, which opens a new browser tab with your shop's front end. The bell icon and number, which indicates the number of new notifications, which by default will show you the last orders, but also two other panels, last registered customers, and new messages. And the personal menu with your profile picture, which contains the My Preferences links to access some personal options and the sign out button. Then on the left, you can find the menu. Here you can browse through the many pages and options of the back office and manage your daily activities and administration of your shop. So let's begin the dashboard. It's the home page of your back office where you can see the main statistics live. It gives an excellent summary of your shop's daily activities at a glance. The dashboard is divided into four main areas, a horizontal bar and three columns. By default, the dashboard uses fake data so that you can better visualize what the various statistics are for. To watch real data of your online store, deactivate the demo mode option. Next, you can use the horizontal bar to choose the period of time for the currently displayed dashboard statistics. Three sets of options are available: current day, current month, current year, previous day, previous month, and previous year, as well as a precise date selection. You can also compare two periods of time together by checking the Compare To box. Select the second period as you would for the first one and then click the Apply button. When comparing two periods, some of the content blocks will update to indicate the evolution of the data. In the left column, you can find the main figures from your database at a quick glance. Online visitors in the last 30 minutes, active shopping carts in the last 30 minutes, currently pending orders, including returns and exchange inquiries, abandoned carts, and out of stock products. Notifications for new messages, orders, inquiries, and product reviews. New customers and newsletter subscriptions. Traffic statistics, visits, unique visitors, traffic sources, and direct links. In the central column, there are the most important numbers pertaining to your shop's daily activities, along with a graph and sales, and a list of the latest orders. This is where you see your shop live and breathe. By default, there are three blocks of content in this column, which are handled by modules. The first module being the dashboard. With various graphics, it helps you see if your shop is heading in the right direction or not. Click on one of the graphic types to display it. Additionally, when comparing two timelines, it displays an evolution of the data of each figure in percentages. Click its configuration icon open a new page and you can see the various expenses that your shop has in order to better indicate your trends. Next, your forecast. It presents you with the goals you have for the coming months and how your shop is doing to compare to them. Depending on your monthly results, you should update your forthcoming goals. You can set your goals in the blocks configuration form at the top right and fill in your expectations month per month in terms of traffic, conversion rates, average cart value. The sales, these will be updated according to the goals set in the other columns. You can change the currency in the currencies page under the localization menu. Products and sales. This module presents you with a table of your latest orders and the rankings of your products, best sellers, most viewed, and your top searches. You can set the number of items displayed in each by opening the blocks configuration form. Finally, the last column gives you the latest news from PrestaShop.com, notifications about new PrestaShop versions, and useful links. Below the dashboard, the menu is organized into three main sections, from the pages you use to the most frequently to the least often. Under these sections, each menu applies to a given set of tasks or contexts. And the first section is sell. It's all about your day-to-day activity, orders, customers, catalog, etc. This section presents the essence of your business and where you go each day to get your business going. Orders. Once clients start adding products into their shopping carts, you will see the orders in this menu with the resulting invoices. This is also where you'll handle your credit slips and abandoned carts, among other things. The catalog. This is the heart of your shop, where you'll be adding products, creating categories, setting up carriers and suppliers, and defining discounts, etc. And customers. Here you can access all the information about your clients and edit their addresses. Customer service, where you handle customer service and anything post-purchase, merchandise returns, pre-orders, and customer service, etc. Statistics. This menu gives you access to all the numerous statistics and graphics that are gathered and generated by PrestaShop. The second section is improve. Here you'll find everything to customize your shop and take your business further. Set up the look of your front office, adapt your payment methods to the target markets, expand internationally, or enhance your shop with the new modules and features. Modules. Extend the power and usefulness of your shop by adding and activating modules. More than 100 are available by default, and many more available to buy on the add-ons marketplace at addons.prestashop.com. Design. This is where you'll handle themes and where you can position the blocks of content for your modules on the theme. More generally, this is where you can modify the look of your shop. Shipping. Everything pertaining to carriers and shipping costs. And payment. Select here which payment methods are available on your shop and apply global settings to payment modules. And international. Here you can customize your shop with local values such as language, translations, currency, units, taxes and tax rules, and geographical entities. And the last section, configuration. This one is divided into two submenus. The first one is your shop parameters, and you'll find here all the settings you need to configure when you're launching your activity. Shop parameters made your initial choices, and you won't go there very often. You can edit just about any of its behavior using these full featured preferences. And the second menu, Advanced Parameters, contains links to the tools and informational pages that are too specific to fit in other menus, such as the web server settings, database backup tool, or performance page, among others. This is also where settings pertaining to the back office itself, for instance, the content of the employee list and permissions. These are the default menus. Note that modules can also add new options and existing pages, new pages to the existing menus, and even new menus. Some of these menus are further divided into pages with tabs to present you with a variety of features available in PrestaShop. If you have any doubt, the Help button is available near the Demo Mode button. Here, the software's documentation is directly embedded into the administration interface. Thanks for watching this PrestaShop 1.7 tutorial video, and we'll see you for the next one.